Hi, I'm Emily. I used to be a fourth grade teacher before I joined the Flocabulary team. If you're new to Flocabulary, I found it's best to go short and simple. In 15 to 20 minutes, you can share a video with your class, have a discussion, and have students take a short quiz. That approach is a great way to start to get to know our content and lesson sequence. The videos are awesome. Most often the whole class watches together and students sing along and sometimes dance. You could also assign the video to be watched as homework and then debrief about it the next day. A great thing about assigning it that way is that they can watch it at a speed that works best for them. After the video is a great time for discussion. I know a lot of teachers come up with their own prompts, but they're psyched to learn that they can also use discuss mode, where questions will just pop up throughout the video. Students turn and talk to a partner, and then they share out. Sometimes there's really great debate. Sometimes students make amazing connections to other things that they're studying. It's a really great way to get everyone in your class involved. After the video and the discussion, there's a quiz to get a sense of how much they've learned. The 10 questions cover a combination of content, skills, and vocabulary from the lesson. Teachers often assign it to their students to do online. It's auto-graded, and there's a comprehension analysis, which will tell you the pieces that you might want to reteach. If you don't want to do it online, you can always print the quiz instead. So that's it. Those three pieces: the video, the discussion, and the quiz. They will get students engaged, talking, listening, and learning core content. Teachers get a lot of use out of the other great activities in Flocabulary, but I recommend using that short and simple sequence if you're just starting out.